Okay, so this is going to be the Cityscape one. This, if I'm being really honest, is going to be a bit more challenging. Now, the way I've drawn it out is I've actually got, I feel like I might want to, no, I'm not going to go over it too hard. The problem is, you don't want to do your planning too hard with your pencil, because then it kind of defeats that point of you being able to see each section with just the colour if you give it that really hard outline. Now, so what I'm going to have to think carefully about is, I've done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sections and I've got my 3 colours here. Now I could whack in a purple if I wanted, but I really don't want to. I want to try and keep that subtlety of the colour. I also want to give myself the opportunity to show off colour mixing skills. So as much as I'll start off with my yellow here, going into my orange and end up with my red there, I've got the opportunity to make it so that my first layer is my yellow, my third layer is my orange, and my fifth is my red, but the ones in between will be a mixture of the two. And obviously if you're able to show colour mixing, you're able to get those higher marks when we're looking at how you can manipulate your colour and your colour theory knowledge. So, here goes. Yeah. Top tip, by the way, use your fingers as your little guiders. Gives you a little bit of control over what you're doing. I'd also say go back over it from a couple of different directions, almost like you're sort of cross-hatching it. It gives a much better finish, even if it's not like a full-on block. It either way will give a nicer finish to that bit of colouring in. Right, one. Okay, so here comes the blend. It does make it quite a bit more subtle. Tell you what, probably if I use that sort of cross-hatching method again.